Hello everyone, this is Sam Spade and welcome to another Coding Fundamentals and GML tutorial. In this tutorial, we're going to be talking about macros. A macro is a single word that stands for something else, such as a single value or a complex expression. Essentially, they are text replacement or copy and paste. You tell GameMaker what you want this word to stand for. You then use that word throughout your code. And when the game is compiled, GameMaker goes through and replaces that word with what you wanted it to stand for. They are also constants, which means they cannot be changed. Macros are great because they allow you to use shorthand to reference things in code or name things to be more helpful. And this helps make your code more readable, searchable, and maintainable. So for example, here we have item equals none. None is a macro that I use in most of my projects. It's simply -1. Or here we have if coin flip, where coin flip is an expression. And it doesn't matter what that expression is for the moment, just the idea that we can take a complex expression and turn it into a single word that we can now use in our code. Before we get into actually creating macros, let's talk about a couple rules. Much like enums, they can be created anywhere, but they must be unique and they cannot be changed after the game is compiled. They are also constants. So to create a macro, you must first use the macro keyword, or hashtag macro, then the macro itself, the word that you're going to use throughout your code, and then what you're going to replace that word with when the game is compiled. So none, -1, setup, event 0, pause, event 10, mypy, 3.14, blue, the hex code for blue, flip coin, choose true or false. Flip coin is a great example of a more complex expression because it allows you to take this function, choose true or false, which will just return either true or false with a 50-50% chance, and turn it into a single phrase. Once you've created a macro, you can simply use it. So here we have image blend equals blue. Again, blue is the hex code. So when this code is compiled, this is going to be replaced with this. Or if flip coin, do something, where again, flip coin will be replaced with choose true or false, making this a statement that just evaluates 50% of the time to doing this thing and 50% of the time to not doing that thing. Let's briefly talk about the difference between macros and enums. Both macros and enums are constants. They cannot be changed once the game is compiled. Both macros and enums can be created anywhere in your code, and once created, can be referenced anywhere else, and they can both be created in code that is not even called, for example, in a script. And macros and enums must both be unique. However, enums are data types, and enums are only named integers, whereas macros are text replacement. They're not their own data type. It's simple copy and paste. And macros can be complex expressions. They can be much more than named integers. They can also be any number. They can be decimals. They can be values, true or false. They can be entire function or multiple functions all put together. So in summary, macros are named sections of code, which can be single values or complex expressions, and they work like copy and paste. As always, the links in this slide will be below, along with links to the source code and the slides themselves. One thing I want to add is that I've linked to a video on GM Wolf's channel that talks about using macros with the precompiler and also references configuring macros, which is something we didn't talk about here because it's a little bit more advanced. So if you want to learn a little bit more about the advanced functionality of macros, I would go watch that video. All right, that's it. Thanks for watching.